This video is brought to you by Diamond Pacific Tool Corporation. Diamond Pacific is America's favorite diamond tool, wheel, and lapidary machine manufacturers. For nearly half a century, Diamond Pacific has set the industry standard for diamond lapidary equipment. Join the majority of professional lapidaries and choose Diamond Pacific products such as their Nova Wheels, Pixie, Genie, and Titan gem makers, as well as their wide selection of other high-quality lapidary diamond products. Check out Diamond Pacific today and find out why they're considered America's premier diamond lapidary tool manufacturers.
Howdy, y'all. I got my old TS-10. It's actually not old. I think I got it like 4 years ago for $280 new. A friend of mine actually messaged me and said they were about to go up in price. And I got it for $280, 10-inch trim saw. Then they went up to like four something, or then maybe five before they were discontinued, I think. Don't quite remember what they went up to, but got an old motor, so it kind of bogs a bit. Dogs out, you know. But it works. So I'm trimming up stuff that I want to get done before I have to go back to California and Wisconsin. Some of the stuff I'm going to take with me. I've been processing some of that red marcasite from Indonesia. This stuff is just fabulous. I bought two cores of it at the Quartzsite show. They're cross cores. So it's like a core, like not just a center core, but when they do a center core, then they cross core the outside of that. I'll just show you really quick. It is a mess. But yeah, I'm gonna just do some roughly unedited cuts. I'm not gonna speed things up and slab with me. It'll be fun. I'm gonna do this big, beautiful piece of turquoise, some chrysoprase, some jade, and some other stuff. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't done so already. Thank you so much for the 50,000 subscribers. It really means a lot to me. The jump from 25 to 50 was a lot easier than zero to like 2,500. I think that took me like 4 years. But I'm happy the community's grown so much to where we can help each other out. We really need to be subscribing to each other. The creators that don't have 1,000 subscribers, we really need to work together to get them there. I have some ideas for that in the future. But in the meantime, if you follow anybody, and you have any extra accounts or multiple accounts, go subscribe to your friends. I'm making a whole nother channel, and I'm going to make sure to do that. Yeah, let's have some fun. It'll be cool. This stuff can be pretty expensive, like $50 for like a slab. I think this was $6 a pound for these weird cross cores. Not ideal for slabbing. They call this a trim saw. That's why it's TS-10, trim saw 10. But you can do more than trim on it. Obviously, you can process some big things on it. I think it's a Johnson Brother blade or an MK. I don't remember. It's a really nice blade, sintered. I don't even remember where I got it. It makes a mess. I need to create like a little valve with a plug. My grandfather's been cutting a lot of catlinite. He makes chinupa. And so it's just red stuff everywhere, all over me, all over everything. But it's kind of a cool, if you're going to be covered in sludge, catlinite's a cool sacred stone to be covered in. I have water in it. So yeah, I'm not going to be covered in oil. I think this could probably use both. I'm not really into hand operated oil salts. Let's do it. Start off with this chrysoprase. Last time I was cutting it, I was cutting it on my little 4-inch trim saw with the thinnest blade you can get on Amazon. Not the best way to do this material. I think I'm going to cut it long ways like this. Looks a little bit brighter on this side here. The curve of the blade's pretty thick, but not the thickest. It's alright. That'll keep it quiet. I'm obviously gonna lower the volume when I start cutting. kind of had a little bit of a break there. It looks like it just got really thin. So some people, they cut the end cuts thick so that they're usable. Some people cut them thinner so that you just have a nice freshly planed piece to make some better slablets. I usually do the thinner, but not a big deal. Doesn't look like there's a fracture right here, so it's probably going to break a lot more. I think I'm going to cut it this way now. Not the highest quality stuff. It's still really cool. Looks like the muddy matrix is less fluorescent this way. So they're going to work that a bit. I expect it to break right here. So with the chrysoprase, when it's really jammy, I do cut it thicker like this, because the thinner you cut the chrysoprase, even when it's jammy, it kind of loses some color. This is not the case. This is a great color, but low quality matrix. Still. Best consistency and thickness, obviously a little thinner than over here. This saw does have one of those clamps that go on the side with the vices. It's sold separately. This one was cheaper than the one that came with that. And I think when you get that, you can get like a hood for this. So you're just kind of rocking the vise and not getting soaked like I am here right now. At the time, every dollar counted, so I got this one. Really happy I did when I did. This company's out of business as of this year. Thank you. when it comes to the lower quality crucifers, it's real muddy. I almost want to like stabilize it. Obviously, it's not going to penetrate the chalcedony, but the matrix, especially when I hit it with like a compound, it's stuck in there. If I was using just wheels, which I should get a setup of just wheels, like 14,000, 50,000, 150,000. Because then you don't really need compounds. It just takes a lot longer. Not a lot longer. It just takes longer. And that's good for, like, buggy stuff that you'll get pastes and compounds stuck in. But for this Chrissy Praise, I think I might send it to Virgil and have him stabilize it just for the mud. So I'm actually going to move the camera to come from the other side now to so that we can, when I show the slab, let's see it better. Sun. Is it there? Alright, next I have this beautiful piece of turquoise from Nevada, a big piece of seam. I'm going to just cut a little bit of the matrix, so pretty much like right there. There might even be some color when it opens up, and I'll work the other side, but just process it a tiny bit. I don't know if I've ever cut a piece of turquoise this big before. Natural. It's about to storm. I gotta get there. Gotta wind this up. Forgot to mention, when you're doing shrimp fall work like this, you definitely want to wear eye protection. And Lenny went out and bought some of these goggles. Maybe wear a little bit more than that, but these are bubble wrap. Have to keep things flying in the eyeballs. Oh yeah. I can just take the water straight to the dome. I don't want to mess this up. You know what? I'm actually going to slice this right here so I can look into the vein a little bit better. This right here, hopefully it doesn't just crumble on me. That'd be fun to play with. Kind of has that Tonopah look. Don't know though, Providence lost. Yeah, now we got a nice little base. It kind of just crumbled on me. I'm going to send this away to get stabilized. It's just too nice, too natural, too old to sacrifice, like, silly way of trying. The turquoise is way harder than the most. That is some good looking blue. Alright, let's do some of the marcasite. Alright, here's that big old cross cut, beautiful red marcasite core. From Indonesia, they're obviously making spheres. I'm gonna just cut this right here and then work like that. Sometimes you get some weird muddy spots on this, which can't be polished like this. It's just like super pits of mud or something. So if I have to change the orientation of my cuts, I will do that. Is that the word you use, orientation? Anyway, boom, boom. Hopefully we can do that in one, then maybe go this way. We'll see what happens. Just don't want that muddy stuff. Those are pretty, just maybe small pieces. So this one looks like it has a lot less of that mud than the other one. I don't know if the best thing to do is to go this way or to just do boom, 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 boom. I guess we're gonna go sideways. Some of the mud. For the most part, that looks really good. I should have cut it a little bit thinner. I think I'm going to recut that. Maybe one, just the cab would just be too big. Somebody's saying, but David, the druzy! Oh, yeah, that's more usable. We still have the druze, and then we have a totally usable piece here to carry. That was good. And now we're lined up to cut some decent little spotlets. Thank you. bit less of the red. It's still cool. And I don't even care that there's not a ton of Arkosite throughout it. Just a few spots make it really special. For agates, this is roughly the thickness I like. I don't want them too thick. It really depends on the material. Unfortunately, what the Pest Red is a damn mud pit. But that's okay. So, diamond saws abrade. They don't really slice. So I'm trying to get the most speed. There's no point in me like digging in and slowing it down and applying pressure. The pressure is not really helping. Way too thin. Way too thin. That's usable, but the rest, it's pretty. I'll probably put double-sided tape, polish it on a Richardson, and make a pendant out of it. Like a really nice thin agate pendant or something, but not really settable. You can't have a dome. I blame my my muddy goggles over here. I'm gonna clean them up before I slice them. $6 core, cross core. Not bad for this material. This stuff is pretty expensive. It's kind of like carnelian with marcasite. This stuff gets really red when it wants to be.
more of an orange, but still nice. I'm gonna actually pressure wash these, since a lot of it will just pop right out of the back. There'll be voids cut around it and stuff. Some of them I'll leave like little jerseys. This piece of the Chris, not the highest quality, but still really cool. It's probably my favorite piece of the mark. Carnelian. Indonesia is so rich with amazing material. I think the reason why we don't see much more of it, people are intimidated to buy because all the horror stories of people getting ripped off online. And you never really see just like dedicated Indonesian booths at like Tucson and Denver. There's room for that. Like, you see a lot of people who go to Indonesia a lot and they bring back like the grape agate, which, believe it or not, grape agate is extremely affordable when you buy it direct. I'm talking like pieces like this big for like 30, 40 bucks. But I guess, you know, in Denver and Tucson, they're not really focused on slabbing material. They're like finished goods. There are people that sell that stuff, like McKay and the Miners Co-op folks on the outside of those venues, but no dedicated Indonesian booths. That'd be cool to see some of their wood opals, some of their rainbow petrified woods, this material in higher qualities, their gem silica for sure. Anyway, let's do some more cuttings. All right, so I'm going to start off with this piece. I think this is a piece of opaque Guatemalan given to me by my good friend Daniel, who deals in the Morgan Hill. And it's not very translucent. It's mostly opaque. So a lower quality, still probably rocking at about, $40 to $80 a pound. And then I'm trying to think how to cut this. This stuff is just like super dark, almost black. It's not really black. I mean, it's kind of black, but it's just so dark. I really want to make earrings out of this. I wanted to make just two gigantic earrings and set them in gold. I have those slabs already, so I'm thinking maybe I'll either cut it this way and get these longer strips, cut it this way and get like these little tabbies. Because if I go this way, I might as well just wait to get my slab saw back, chuck it up on a wood block, and have it cut really nice, straight cuts. Because I want this thin. I am not trying to really make cabochons out of this. I want to make, like, jewelry. So, I think I'll take a couple pieces off of here. And then just wait for my slab saw. Virgil fixed it for me. So when you have things that you can't really chuck very easily, or that your vise isn't going to get in front of the blade, people use epoxies, some people use wood glue or water glass, some people cover it in a Bondo and chuck it that way. I'm going to use wood glue with a block of wood, and then the wood gets chucked, and then you slice it that way. But we'll get a couple pieces, make some earrings or something, and this we're going to just process all the way. Now, this stuff is not that hard, but it's really tough. So we'll see how fast I can do this. I wonder what way I should cut this. I don't really want to go this way. Maybe like this. We'll see.
So I'm thinking I could chuck it and cut it like this all day long, nice and clean. This is really nice fracture-free material. So that was kind of dumb. So I'm not going to do that anymore. I don't have another saw here, so I'm okay with having one to work on. It's really nice for maybe sell it or give it away or do something with it. To my grandfather to carve truck wall. Light inside of it. Yeah, still no translucency on it. You gotta get it really thin. Did you even know it was jade? It's a little bit as well. Anyway, so same goes for this Guatemalan. I guess I do see some fractures right here. Not so much going this way. This way, yeah, I see something right there actually. But you know, we're gonna slice it long ways just to get a longer piece. I don't know. I could chuck this and get it like this if I just waited, but I want at least one piece to cut. Decision. definitely need to deglaze my blade more often. It's a sintered blade, so it's diamonds inside of like soft metals, and the metal can kind of glaze the diamond. I think the diamond glazes inside. So not very translucent, but a little bit more. At least we have something to play with. Yeah, this stuff, I don't know what it's worth. It could be worth $5 a pound, it could be worth $40 a pound. But it definitely deserves to get a real cut, not these dirty cuts that we want to sell. So. But instant gratification, for sure. Next piece is a beautiful piece of Haiti mountain jazz agate. It might be from the top notch area. Nah, I think it is. It's from the top notch. Harvested by Bill Depew. We bought this from the rock yard. Get a couple slices of it. It's really cool. It's yeah, you can see how much faster this went than the jade, and I think this is technically harder, but it's not as tough. Some cool purples in there. Reds. That's good at this one. See where that material opens up right here. It's away from the light. night's cool. That purple's great. Just to get a nice flat spot. Nice and flat. Some Southern California marcasite from the Diamond Pacific Rock Yard. Don't really know what to expect from it. Maybe there's nothing in it, just kind of just stuff on the outside. We're gonna take a look. Yeah, nothing. sometimes it has cool veins through it. Not this one. Alright, next we got some Morgan Hill. I've heard that the stuff is so fractured because of blasting. I don't know the real story. McKenzie's going to tell me. This is given to you by my good friend Daniel. You know, we have to work around fractures. It's still pretty cool. Not so much of the poppy on this one. I'm going to do a cut this way. To start it off, we cut off this guy. So, me twisting like that, that's not a very good thing. Because when I'm twisting it, you saw how the blade stopped? Well, it could bang out a piece of that blade. And then, like, if there's a piece of the blade missing, even though I can touch it right now, it can be really dangerous afterwards. And when I'm spinning it like that, and I have it up here, that's a bad thing. If it's a blade, it can get stuck in the blade and slam on the table. And then that's a bad thing, so... This is not the best way to go about doing this kind of stuff. That's what I'm doing. Let's do it. Let's cut this one. Yeah, it's way better cut this way. That's fraction right here. That looks pretty clean. It's a little something like that. Poppy Jasper, this particular piece. Some of the other stuff that I got from Dan is pretty fabulous, but definitely playful, definitely worth cutting. Definitely cool. Some good poppies right there. Here's a big, beautiful red one. Piece of that Morgan Hill poppy. Sweet Jim gave me, unfortunately, just like the other piece, a lot of fractures. Super curious about what causes that in this material. This one's got some great stuff going on it. Definitely can work around it, but you would want that. And if you can't have it, that stinks. Here's another variation. This is the first piece I've ever cut. This is a black variation of the Morgan Hill Poppy Jasper. I think people would probably just call this Morgan Hill Jasper because it has no poppies in it, but it's really good looking. And then two other kinds. We're gonna slab up these. I'm gonna get another slab of this. Here's a little one too. That's the stuff. Literally, the poppy in the poppy jasper. That is sick.
these pieces are fracture free. That was fracture there. They kind of popped up. That is awesome. Wonder if stabilizing it is worth it. It's really hard. I can't be snapping. Still open. Piece is neat, but it's looks more like the black. It's got a lot of fractures. This is neat. Let's do this big red and yellow one. I'm gonna do a little cut right here just to see inside of it. Maybe we can read it better. Like it was getting into the poppy on this left side. Definitely seems like this is the direction to cut this material. Do it. furniture piece that popped off the big pump. No, it's colorful, not much to talk about. I'm actually going to collect everything, as I always do, but I'm going to tumble some stuff here soon. It's definitely pretty. Pinks and purples and orange, yellow. No poppies though, on that. It's all right, definitely fractured. So it's less fractured, cap, butt end of this. I'm going to use this flat spot now and cut it sideways. It kind of looks like the same editing variation throughout. Still cool. These look like the best. Little things going down at the top, and besides that, really cool. It's a little hard for me to show you on camera, but the yellow in there, it's like electric. I like it a lot. Okay, last but not least, when it comes to this Morgan Hill, we're going to do This stuff is pretty much fracture free as well. Been holding on to this stuff maybe, damn, 4 or 5 years. But not least, for the evening, it's getting dark out here and very cloudy. This is nice piece of plasma agate. This came from Sweet Jim. There's a blue variation, there's a green variation. Somebody gave me a small piece of the blue in quartzite. Sweet Jim loved this material. It's pretty cool. It can be pretty translucent. Some people say that they've seen just straight seams of the actual plasma agate that's colorful. I have not. This material is from California, Central California. Sometimes it has these cool reds. Anyway, let's chop it up. Stuff definitely is pretty. I think I'm just going to leave this uncutting on. I'll trim it at least. Anyway, that was fun. Let's go get this stuff cleaned up.